Hey gang, we're out here in the garage today. We're going to build a camp kitchen. Our camp kitchen is going to be a little different than some people's camp kitchen. Ours is going to be mobile. It's going to have a grill on it. It's going to have a sink on it. It's going to have a food preparation area and a cooler for storing your beverages. Our camp kitchen is going to be, like I said, it's going to be high speed, low drag. We're going to have a set of racing slicks on it, aluminum wheels, anodized billet aluminum hubs. We're going to trim this bad boy out with some polished aluminum diamond plate. We got a brand new RV stainless steel sink that we're going to mount in it. We got a brand new grill to put on one end of it. We got some go-kart front suspension parts that we're going to use for steering it. And then we got some square tube that we're going to put together and make our own chassis for it. So stay tuned. We're going to put together a camp kitchen for high-speed, low-drag camping. All right, the front suspension on our camp kitchen uses a kingpin type of front suspension. We're going to have steering arms right here that actually come from a go-kart. I've went ahead and welded those to some square tube, made our front clip. We're going to go ahead and bolt this all together and show you how it all works. All right, guys, we've got the front steering mechanism all together. Now, what I've done is I've already put my front wheels on it and checked the spacing between the inside of the rim and tire with the knuckle here on the steering mechanism. And then I bought a set of spacers and took these in and chucked them up in the lathe and I turned them to the right length so that my hubs put my tires as close to my steering mechanism as I can get it without anything rubbing. So we'll put the nuts on here, we'll mark the front axle, chop it off to length.
Tin welders are pretty handy, but they're not, they like to stick a little bit here and there. We've got our frame all jigged up here, but I start tacking it together, do a little welding on it, and we get it that we feel like we've got it squared up pretty good. You know, we're not racing this grill, so I'm not super picky about how square as long as the grill and the cabinets all line up. I just want to make sure that it's level. And that is strong enough to hold all the stuff I want to put on it. So we'll get it measured out here, make sure we're pretty square. Square enough to mount all our cabinets on, at least. And then tack it in place and then put some gloves on. Looks like the camp kitchen's coming along. Alright, got the chassis all welded together. So we're ready to start mounting the grill and building our cabinet there, mount the sink in, and we've got a lot of frame work left to do for all that stuff, so we'll start working on that. I think the first thing I'm going to try to do is figure out a frame to get the grill out over the front tires a little bit, make sure that we got enough room for our gas tank underneath it, and start to make some progress finally in the camp kitchen. We'll work on getting the grill mounted up.
Hey guys, we got the chassis put together. We're starting to make our mounts for the grill. Got a little work to do there. We just kind of tacked it in place to
get an idea if that's going to work out for us or not, but so far it's looking pretty good. So what we're going to have is a pretty much a full grill at the campground. And we'll enclose the bottom of that, probably put a diamond plate aluminum door on it. We'll see how what we come up with when we get to that point. Then back here we'll have a storage cabinet and have to put in a sink and then the water tank. And we're still debating on whether to make a mount for a cooler to go out here back over the rear tire. So we're right on the camp kitchen, so we'll keep working on it and keep updating the video. Okay, we're still working on the frame here. We've got a few ideas. We've mocked up our grill. I went ahead and threw a quick coat of black paint on the frame. We're going to be touching all that up because we still have quite a bit of welding to do, but I didn't want things to start rusting before we can get it put together. So yeah, we're maybe tossing around the idea of diamond plating the bottom of it here and leaving the underneath the grill open. Afraid that we might generate some heat on the bottom side of the grill if we tried to store anything in there, although it was originally designed that way. We'll see. But what we're going to do, we're going to butt up to the grill here. We're going to put a tabletop up on top of here. It'll come all the way across, rest here. We're going to enclose this into one cabinet underneath. Put our sink there. So got a couple ideas for some rear fenders on the back tires. Still throwing around putting the grill or a cooler on the back side here. So camp kitchen starting to take some shape. All right, guys, we're just going to show you some of the progress we've made on the camp grill here. We've added a back section here. This is where our sink's going to go. And we've framed in where the drawer is going to go in the front of it. And our bottom cabinet frame there. I do a little work on our grill mount. It was a little bit out of square, so we cut that back apart and made some adjustment and re-weld it back together to get it good and even. And so there's the progress on the camp grill. Get you a good look at it. Okay, we did a little more framework up here on the front end. We got the front all finished out, framed in, ready to be skinned. Back of it's ready to be skinned. We've added the cross braces in here to handle the extra weight from the water tank and a battery. We'll have four doors on the front of it and a big drawer. And, so progress today on the camp kitchen. We'll keep taking videos as we get done with it. We've got our countertop ordered. Got our water pump ordered. We're still trying to find some suitable material to skin it. I wanted to do a roll coated aluminum skin on it, but having a little trouble finding the roll coat aluminum in the color I wanted. I can get it in white, yellow, orange, and red, and I really wanted black for that. So we'll get our aluminum here figured out. We may end up just using sheet metal and painting it, so we'll figure out what we're going to do to skin it, and then hopefully next video you see we'll have some skin on this thing. Okay, one of the things we wanted to do, we wanted to put a drawer in this. So we welded a couple rails going across the frame here so that we could attach a set of slides. And we went to Lowe's, bought some roller bearing slides like you'll see in a toolbox. And then once it slides back, it actually latches into place so that our drawer won't come sliding open on us. While it's in transport, it's kind of locked shut. And then all we did was weld a couple
pieces of angle iron across there, screw the slides into it evenly, making sure that we got them good and level. Then now what we gotta do is build the drawer. And once we build the drawer, the way this hardware works, you'll have screw holes to screw into the drawer. And they leave you a little access on the slides so that you can get to it to turn your screws or pop rivet or whatever you're gonna do into your drawer. And that's putting the drawer in the camp kitchen. So we'll get busy building our drawer, and that hopefully will be our next video. Seen the slides put in for the drawer. Now we have our diamond plate. I took it into work. Nice medium weight diamond plate aluminum. Cut my drawer out of it. Then I put it in a sheet metal break. I had to actually score the corners before I put it in the brake so that it would bend a little tighter than a regular diamond plate. A regular diamond plate's gonna want to put a big round bend in it. It won't bend like we're wanting. So to get the nice tight corners, I had to score it with a circular saw and a carbide blade. So I cut about a third of the thickness out of it that way, and then put it in a sheet metal brake to get a nice tight corner. And we got our roller bearing slides, just like a toolbox. It kind of latches into place once it goes back, so while this thing's in the move, we won't have to deal with the drawer just coming open. Kind of, you see, kind of takes a little bit of. So once I put the face on it, it should set nice and flush with the frame here. So there's the drawer in the front of our camp kitchen.